guys, what's going on? It's Ash here coming at you today in Clash Royale with a quick bonus news video for you guys. I'd like to keep you updated on what is going on in the game. And in the last week or few days, we've received a bunch of news that I wanted to share with you guys in two major topics that we'll be discussing in today's video. Number one is the new card leaks that came with the client update. Number two is going to be this huge, really, I don't know, one of the biggest bugs slash glitches in Clan Wars in the history of Clash Royale, and we're going to talk about the fallout of that situation, what happened, and what is being done to remedy it, and just kind of catch you guys up on what's going on there. So let's start with the new cards, guys. In the client update, and just a quick disclaimer, this does not mean these cards are definitely coming in the next update. Actually, looking back at the last leak like this that we saw, only one, maybe two of the cards actually ended up coming in the next update, and that was Rascals and maybe Magic Archer, which was Sneaky Archer, which I think was changed to Magic Archer. But the other cards, the Heroes and the Lava Golem, never ended up coming. So again, this is not a lock that these cards will be brought into the game. It's just something that the team has obviously been experimenting with. And also, just like we saw with the Sneaky Archer and Magic Archer, these could be placeholders for other cards. So the disclaimers out there, let's talk about the three cards that we know about here. Number one is the Wallbreaker, and this is translated from Russian, guys, so big shout out to iGameplay on Reddit. I'll include the post where he shared all these cards and the images as well. So the first one is Wallbreaker. It's using the Bomber UI right now, it looks like. The gameplay that you see for this on other channels or whatever is not real. It's just using, again, the Bomber UI, but it looks to be some sort of a Wallbreaker legendary card. Also, from this picture in TV Royale, you can see that there's a legendary bomber over there. It looks like a legendary bomber. And the first thing you're gonna say is, Ash, that is Photoshop, dude. Look at the bomber. You can tell it's a bomber of the legendary thing, the frame on it, right? And well, it was on the official Clash Royale TV Royale video. I think it's an Easter egg of some sort. I could be wrong. It could be a bug or a glitch in the build that they were using for the episode. But usually they're pretty good at catching these things before they go live. So I think it might be an Easter egg, but I'll let you guys decide. Is it real? Is it a crappy idea? Next card is going to be the Electro Dragon, borrowed from Clash of Clans. It looks to be a powerful new chain lightning type dragon card. For those of you who don't play Clash of Clans, it's basically a big electric electro dragon, right? Where his electricity, whatever they are, the beams, basically chain lightning from target to target, getting weaker every time they hit onto a new target. I actually like the idea of the electro dragon added to the game, obviously depending on the mechanics and the stats and everything like that. I think all in all, it is time for a new dragon card. There's only one baby dragon in the game. Oh, there's two. My bad, Inferno Dragon. Well, I think it's time for a third dragon. I'd like to see the Electro Dragon added. Personally, what do you think of the Electro Dragon idea? And the third card is something called the Wolf Rider. Again, that's a Russian translation. Not sure it's exact, but basically by the pictures, it looks like a Hog Rider, a guy on a wolf instead of a guy on a hog. And I have no idea what the mechanics and what the metrics might be like. I'll leave that to you guys to speculate. Maybe it's who knows? I mean, it could spawn little wolves after it dies. It could not target buildings like the Hog Rider does. There's just a million different directions to go with that, so I won't even continue to speculate based on absolutely nothing except for this little picture. So those are the sprites of the new cards that were added in the client update. Again, who knows if they'll really be coming into the game. Now let's talk about this war glitch. So for people who don't know about the war glitch, in a nutshell, really, really concise, abridged version of what happened is there was a glitch for about 30 minutes on Sunday, my time, where people were given the extra pouch of the rewards from Clan Wars again and again and again and again and again. So basically, they could get trade tokens and gold and war wins, and their clan could get war trophies, basically unlimited in the span of that 30 minutes while the glitch was going on in the game if they were online. Now, Supercell has came out three times now and publicly addressed this. So let's cover each of these kind of statements by Supercell. Number one is when they tweeted that they were fixing the leaderboard, which was totally out of whack. OJ put out a video on it if you guys want to go ahead and see what it looked like. But basically, the leaderboard was just clans with thousands and hundreds and thousands of trophies, right? Basically, really, really high trophies because they kept winning and winning and winning and winning and winning and winning and collecting their rewards. So the first tweet by Supercell fixed the leaderboard. So that's all well and good. Now, if you go in game, you won't see any of those inflated clan war trophies on the leaderboard. The second statement on Supercell was on Reddit, and you can read it here, guys. And basically, it says that they're committed to trying to resolve these issues. They said it affected a total of 254 clans in the game. They say only 254 clans, but assuming those clans had, say, 45 members in them each, that's a total of 11,430 people total who could have possibly taken advantage. Now, they had to be online at the time, so probably just a small percentage of that total capacity, but still 11,000 total people to me is a pretty big number, a pretty substantial number of total players who could have hypothetically taken advantage of this glitch. So let's talk about the third statement by Supercell. Basically reiterated the second one, saying that they'd like to roll back the rewards of those players who collected the gold and the trade tokens, but that it would be very difficult to track down the trade tokens, because think about it, people could just keep maxing their trade tokens, trade for new cards, and then just use all the gold they collected to max them out. But of course, they only had 30 minutes to actually do that. Of course, at the end of 30 minutes, they could be sitting on full trade tokens as well. So they said it would be difficult, but they're committed to doing that. In the third statement, they doubled down on that, saying that they are committed to making this right, and they want to take away the gold and the tokens and the war wins on the profiles of those players who took advantage of the glitch. So two questions. Where do we stand now, and who is to blame? What should happen, right? So where we stand now, we're just waiting. There's been no official communication as of this recording by Supercell talking about how this will be resolved and when this will be resolved. Number two is, who is to blame? I think the onus here falls on Supercell. It was their bug, it was their glitch, and obviously having to do with the new kind of pouches that you get associated with Clan Wars with the bonus gold and the trade tokens. I don't know what happened. I am not a developer. I'm not an engineer. I am not a technician. I do not know what happened on the server side or wherever, right, on the client side. So who's to blame? I don't think the people who took advantage of it are necessarily to blame. There's no doubt about it, they took advantage of a glitch, so it's not like they come out looking scot-free here. I do think they deserve to be rolled back. That's the perfect solution. But can they roll back individual accounts? Can they make it seem like the last 24 hours didn't even exist on these accounts? That's the big question. My gut tells me no, they can't. They can roll back a server, but not individual accounts. However, I have no idea. It's just a guess. They said it would be difficult. I think if it was an easy rollback, they probably would have already done it. The second option is to remove all the gold that each of those players spent. Now, I think that's the second best option in my opinion. A lot of people on Reddit are like, they don't deserve to go negative gold. It's not their fault. But at the end of the day, they still spent, you know, up to 3 million gold plus. And if they spent that and invested that in upgrading cards that, you know, ideally they wanted to upgrade, they spent the gold, I think they should be given negative gold and just work their way out of that negative gold. It sucks, but I don't think they should be able to take advantage of the glitch and max out their accounts when everybody else has to grind on ladder or pay or do whatever. It's just not fair. And that could lead to the biggest disaster is people complaining to iTunes and Google that they're, you know, other people were taking advantage of a huge glitch and now their money is devalued. So I think that needs to be solved. And again, Supercell, to their credit, said that this would be resolved, and I'll definitely update you. The third and final option, and OJ hinted on this on his video, and I've seen a lot of tweets about this. I think it's the third best option, and that is giving everybody else in the game trade tokens or gold to make up for this glitch, to kind of put them on equal footing with the hypothetical 10,000 or so people who could have taken advantage of this. I think the real number is really lower, by the way, probably in the hundreds. I don't think that's a great solution, even though it'd be nice to get trade tokens, and I'm sure that's what a lot of you guys would like to have happen here. But I don't know if giving out millions of trade token and billions of gold would make I think it would just compound the issue, and it wouldn't compound the issue, but I don't think it'd be the best solution. The best solution is just to roll back or take away the resources that those small group of players in the grand scheme took advantage of. So guys, that's where we stand with the glitch. I told you guys about the new cards. How are you guys doing? Hope you're enjoying these new segments that I add here and there as double uploads. When I think there's noteworthy news to share with you guys, I'm more than happy to do it. So stay tuned, subscribe, whatever, if you want to go ahead and get notifications for these new news stories as they happen in-game. Guys, huge shout out to Brent Chong, my YouTube partner. Check out his information in the description below. Thank you for watching. I'll see you later on tonight with an amazing video. It's one of my favorites. Bag is back, and he's going to be sharing his top 5 low skill cap trophy pushing decks for all arenas. It's going to be really fun, all live battles. So guys, thank you for watching, and as always, take care, guys.